Some of the key issues that we've dealt with in this conversation today include the abuse of church, of people in the name of the church. In other words, abuses that are being created in the name of kingdom building, which we find unacceptable because it is derogatory. You know, where we have some churches and some church leaders doing engaged in actions that are detrimental to the very life of the people that they're supposed to protect, injuring them psychologically, socially, physically, and spiritually. And the church condemns that in all certain terms, particularly the Christian Council of Ghana and the Ghana Pentecostal and Charismatic Council condemn that in all certain terms, because we think that this is not a healthy way of growing the church. This is not a healthy way of improving on the life and the well-being of our people. And as long as it is not healthy, we believe it's not acceptable to God and therefore not supposed to be part of kingdom business. And we trust that our members will learn to discern the spirits and apply themselves diligently, faithfully, to what scripture mandates us to do. In other words, we are, and other environmental illnesses that are, you know, diarrhea and other issues that are affecting our people, we believe that they are issues that we created ourselves, problems that we created ourselves. And we are appealing to our members, first of all, to learn to live environmental friendly lives, minimize, if not able to avoid, the use of plastics and throwing about waste just indiscriminately. It's not acceptable. We need to have waste bins in our communities, waste bins in our premises, and make sure that our members will use these waste bins in healthy ways and not, you know, dotings in ways that will add to the filth that is in a community. And as we do that, we need to educate our children. We need to educate our people in our community. We all need to be sanitation vigilantes, whereby we learn to correct each other and work with each other. Even as we encourage the government to enforce the rules and the laws of sanitation, because when you have rules and laws and they are not enforced, ultimately what happens? People will have absolute disregard for the rules and laws, and that is not good for our country or for our communities. The other issue we engage is the issue of gay and lesbian rights. More often than not, we have these issues being as a church, and we know that legally and internationally, gay rights is not human rights. So when we're talking about gay rights, we are not talking about human rights. We know human rights are things that uphold the dignity of the individual and the family. And those are the things that the church stands for. Those are the rights that the church stands for, that the church is willing to do anything at any time to defend and to support, and not gay rights. And we therefore issue this statement and condemn in no uncertain terms, you know, this issue of gay rights and lesbian rights in the name of human rights. And all attempts to legalize those processes, you know, the church condemns it, and the church does not support its legalization in any way. Those are some of the key issues we raise among others.
No. Jesus Christ says, "Ye are salt of the earth. If salt loses its taste, then it is of no use again." And that Jesus also described the church as the light, which must be put on the table to give illumination and direction and light to every fiber of our society. So what is Jesus Christ saying? Jesus Christ, we have noticed in this conference that there are Christians in the presidency and the executive. There are Christians in the judiciary. There are Christians in the military. There are Christians in the media. There are Christians in the police service, Christians on the market, Christians everywhere. And if the Christian church in Ghana will live as salt and give direction and illumination, some of these abuses and excesses, the degradation of our environment and corruption in this nation and so on and so forth, we believe that the solution is in the Christian demonstrating that he or she is light. If the men of God and the pastors will use the pulpit rightfully and disseminate the right information and teach the people, and we shall have attitudinal changes, we believe that this nation will move forward. This is one of the central themes that we have discussed today, and we have concluded that the church has a solution. Yes, we are looking up to the enforcement of the law. Yes, we are looking to our political will and other things. But if the church will stand and play their role, we shall have sanity and order in this society of ours.